Hello and welcome to another one of my videos. This one I'd like to do a little bit of an update on hand generators and electricity generation. The last one I got up to was this one here, the yo-yo type one. Now I took it down onto the Amazonian plains north of the Amazon to an indigenous tribe there for field trials, but I was just planning a trip down there to see how it went. And the quarantine hit, and so we've been 3 months at least out of action, and it won't be for a month or two before we get travel back in order, I expect, so it'll have to wait a little bit. But I would like to do a little bit of an update as to where I've got to now and where I intend to go in the future, just for those who are interested and thinking, well, what's happened to that? I am still interested in it, still moving on it, but it's just been on hold for a little bit. So let's take a look and I'll tell you what I've found so far. The first model I took for field trials to the indigenous tribe was this one. It was fine. I put some LEDs on the front so they could use it as a lantern, but without a battery. So it was just use it while you're doing it. They used it. It worked fine and it was good. But unfortunately, they left it with the children and the children played with it and dropped it from a height and it broke. So it shows me that these poles here are not strong enough for children. Strong enough for adults, but not for children. Another problem I was finding with it also is this belt here. I'm finding cars are having less and less inner tubes these days. They're going tubeless. So they're hard to come by and hard to find. So we need to rethink that one. The next model was this yo-yo one. You pull the yo-yo and it works. I did do it with a double wheel and things, but I took it down to the llanos, and unfortunately our car broke down and we had to pack the capacitor bank and lamps in a bag and they got smashed. But I did piece it together there and did get it to work. But the biggest problem was they'd never seen a yo-yo in their life and had no idea how to coordinate the pulling of the string. So I'm interested to see whether they learnt that in this next trip or not, to see whether a yo-yo type will be useful for them.
They have arrived and their light bulb has died and now they're back to a flame. So we have that light. It got damaged in the suitcase, it got broken, but it's still working. And we also have a lamp from a car, so it's working okay. Their other one died, so I'm quite pleased. And trying to teach them how to do that one there, so that's pretty good. It's working fine, the proof so far. And the other one broke and they threw it away, so that was interesting. I'll question them on that tomorrow.
Flautas, sopla la flauta.
So that means the next model, which is this, a yo-yo hand lantern with a smaller wheel, double with the motor here. Possibly I might stick a battery in the handle and some LEDs on here at least, so they can use that as a hand lantern. But I have to see whether they have learnt how to handle a yo-yo. So this one is on hold for testing. So my next test is to take this basic, the hand crank idea, and start using cogs or gears. And that's where I'm going to be working a little bit in the next few tutorials as well. Just engineering and concepts behind gears.